this video, so I've been missing it. I went over to my shelf, all the way over there, took this down, dusted it off, and opened it up, and I found this treasure. Insightful and beautiful at the same time. Images and excerpts. So today we're going to do Southwest. Or tonight rather, I should say, right? Southwest Asia, which is going to cover Little Pakistan. Originally, after it seceded from India, it actually took up the area where it now is located, but also took up the area that we call Bangladesh today, which I suppose would be just out of frame. Saudi Arabia, and other, and much more. So let's see what information we can glean from this introductory summary. Since the time is the Mediterranean Sea. The Red Sea cuts diagonally across the center. In the Caspian Sea, all the way up here, is at the top center with the Arabian Sea. USSR and United States feud for the very oil in which this book is currently talking about. Oil and gas seeps have been known here for thousands of years. In fact, the biblical fiery furnace may well have been the eternal fire still burning near Kirkuk. In Iraq. Honestly, the flat earthers are gonna hate this, but I love this perspective. How it's not just a flat image, but in fact it's more at a slant, as though we were an alien coming to visit from an oblique angle. And this is what we saw. Jagged peaks of the Hindu Kush Range, one of the main mountain systems in Central Asia, tower above the village of Bamiyan, or Bamiyan, sit in a valley in northern Afghanistan. The side of the cliff which rises behind the village is pierced with openings for the cave cells of Buddhist monks. In a niche The center of Afghanistan, like a huge fist, 150 miles wide. Its melting snows make up for scanty rainfall by feeding four rivers. The Helmand. Let's see if I can find them. Thank you. Jalalabad. There it is. Cool. Okay, so there's the Khyber Pass right there. Very cool. Wow. And it actually follows a river. Says an ancient route in Iran once was a buffer state between Rome and Parthia. Spectacular columns of rosy white limestone lined its avenues, and the fortress castle on the summit of the hill was actually built much later by the Turks. Centuries for Syria, the corridor for trade caravans and contending armies. Syria has often known foreign rule. In 1958, it actually joined Egypt to become part of the UAR, United Arab Republic. Jordan was actually created by the British after to the traditions of the ancient Phoenicians, the Lebanese also carry on a thriving trade through the port city of Beirut. Iraq, of course, is the home of the very, very ancient and very important to everyone, at least in the Western world. Still cities which cluster around the rivers, which sometimes still surge over their banks. And most of the land is sun-scorched, all the way over here. majestic tomb inscribed, "I am Darius the Great King, King of Kings, King of this great earth and far and wide." End quote. Now the pomp and glory of the Persian Empire are buried in the poverty of present-day Iran, second largest country in the Middle East. Stretches desolately across an area larger than Texas. Still being explored, this wasteland is one of the largest expanses of sand in the world. Okay, I was wrong. They just gave Israel its entirely own. Israel, established in 1948. The look of the land offers an astonishing variety, from indented cliffs of the Negev Desert to the flat white beaches of the Mediterranean, the dry green of the Jordan Valley, season of the year, the climate ranges from the searing heat of the Dead Sea to the fresh crisp breezes of Galilee, and the temperate northern highlands only 60 miles away. And then Saudi Arabia. Just talking about oil. The present kingdom of Saudi Arabia was first unified by Muhammad in 630 AD in his birthplace Mecca. Here we go.